Hello and welcome to the Commander's Quarters. I'm your host, Mitch. Glad to have you here. Now, usually on the show, we build fun and inexpensive commander decks within a $25 budget. But today's going to be another episode of Break the Bank. On episodes like this one, we're going to take one of our Commander's Quarters decks and up the budget from $25 all the way up to $100. Sometimes you just love a deck so much that you're willing to put a little more into it to get some of those upgrades. And prices on this show are powered by our sponsor, TCG Player. Before we get started today, though, make sure you go check out our new classic pink playmat and Commander's Quarters t-shirts on thecommanderscquarters.com. And thank you to everyone who's already purchased our merchandise. It really does help support the channel. Also, make sure that you subscribe to the channel and click that little bell notification icon so that you can stay up to date on the latest Commander's Quarters episodes. Today's Break the Bank episode is on Arcades the Strategist. Now, if you haven't seen this Commander's deck tech yet, make sure you watch that first, so go ahead and click that link in the top right. That deck tech is going to take you through the strategy, tactics, and how to win with the deck. Whereas Break the Bank episodes like this one are going to show you how to upgrade the deck. I just need to make a quick disclaimer before we get started. When people ask me what I would swap out for the reasonable upgrades for a deck, I always tell them that it depends on your meta and your playstyle. So these upgrades in this video are going to be 100% from my perspective. And that perspective is going to differ from person to person, so just keep that in mind. Alright, now that we're on the same page, let's get into it with what's in. First up, there's Cerulean Caretaker, which is a 0/3 defender that can tap to tap an untapped creature we control to add one mana of any color to our mana pool. This is just a great way for us to help ramp and fix our mana with a defender. Another defender that's great at this is Sylvan Caryatid. It's a 0/3 defender with hexproof, and it can tap to add one mana of any color to our mana pool. While its stats aren't the best, it's very hard for our opponents to deal with because of that hexproof. And next up, there's Sunscape Familiar, which is another 0/3 defender. And even though it's just a 0/3, it is a huge addition to this deck by helping us reduce the cost of our green and blue spells by 1. So if we can get this creature down early, we can significantly speed up our deck. And then we've got some defenders with some valuable sacrifice effects. First, there's Portcullis Vine, which is a 0/3 defender which we can pay 2 and tap it to sacrifice a creature with defender to draw a card. So if we're desperate and need to dig deeper into our deck, this card can definitely help us do that. Also, if one of our other defenders is about to die, we can just sacrifice them instead to get value out of them. And then there's Resolute Watchdog, which is a 1/3 defender which we can pay 1 to sacrifice it to make target creature we control indestructible until the end of the turn. This card can come in huge at saving one of our key creatures, especially when that creature's our commander. Next up, we're going to be adding in Perimeter Captain, which is a 0/4 defender that says whenever a creature you control with defender blocks, you may gain 2 life. Although we won't be doing too much blocking with this deck, it helps that this applies to any of our defenders blocking. And then we're going to be running some big beaters with Shield Sphere and Tree of Redemption. Shield Sphere is a 0/6 defender that costs 0. And when Arcades is in play, it's basically a 6/6 for 0, which is just absolutely incredible. It does have that whenever it blocks, we have to put a -0/-1 counter on it, but we're not going to be blocking a lot with this card. And then Tree of Redemption is a 0/13 defender that we can tap to exchange our life total with Tree of Redemption's toughness. Again, with our commander in play, this is effectively a 13/13 for 4. And if we're running really low on life and we're desperate, we can use its ability to get our life total back up to 13. Next up, we're going to be adding in High Alert, which is an enchantment that says each creature you control assigns combat damage equal to its toughness rather than its power. Creatures you control can attack as though they didn't have defender and pay 2 white-blue untapped target creature. This is a fantastic new addition to the deck, which is just basically another form of Arcades on the battlefield. And then we're going to be adding in Panharmonicon, which is an artifact that says if an artifact or creature entering the battlefield causes a triggered ability of a permanent you control to trigger, that ability triggers an additional time. So as long as we have this and our commander in play, we're going to be drawing 2 cards every single time one of our defenders enters the battlefield. Finally, we're going to be upgrading our protection package with Heroic Intervention and Ghostway. Heroic Intervention is an instant that says permanents you control gain hexproof and indestructible until end of turn. This is a very cheap and effective way of protecting every single one of our permanents from either targeted removal or from wraths. And finally, there's Ghostway, which is just pretty much another eerie interlude. It's an instant that says exile each creature you control, return those cards to the battlefield under their owner's control at the beginning of the next end step. So like Eerie Interlude, this card not only protects our creatures, but it also draws us a ton of cards when all those defenders come back into play. So we've talked about some great upgrades for the deck, but what are we taking out for those cards? It's time to go on to what's out. First up, we're going to be taking out some of our ramp cards with Search for Tomorrow and Drover the Mighty. Search for Tomorrow can just be a bit too slow for this deck. And Drover the Mighty, while it does help ramp and fix our mana, it's not a defender, so it can't really help us in other ways. Next up, we're going to be taking out Gatecreeper Vine and Gleaming Barrier. While both of these cards are defenders, we've got better options that we're adding in. Gatecreeper Vine doesn't really ramp us because it just gets that land into our hand. And while Gleaming Barrier does give us a treasure token when it dies, that's only a temporary form of ramp. And then we're going to be removing Shifting Wall, which is a 0/0 defender that costs X, and it comes into play with X++1 counters on it. There are just plenty of better defender options that we have at our disposal when it comes to a bigger budget. Because in order for this to be an effective card, we actually have to put a decent amount of mana into it. Next up, we're going to be taking out a couple of defenders that can gain us life. Pride Guardian is a 0/3 defender, and when it blocks, we gain 3 life. And Jani Offshoot is a 0/3 defender with landfall. When a land enters the battlefield under your control, you gain 1 life. Now, neither of these are bad cards, but Perimeter Captain just does a better job at gaining us life. And then we're going to be taking out some other defenders that aren't too impactful with Novice Knight and Consulate Skygate. These are fine options for our normal budget, but when we increase that budget, these are easily taken out. Next to go is Geist of the Archives, which is a 0/4 defender that says at the beginning of your upkeep, scry 1. Now, scrying 1 is a pretty decent effect, but this is a pretty small body for its mana cost. Plus, we've got some better ways to provide us with card advantage with our upgrades. And finally, we're going to be taking out some of our recursion effects. First, there's Coffiner's Urn, which is an artifact that says whenever a creature with toughness 4 or greater is put into your graveyard from play, you may exile it. At end of turn, if 3 or more cards have been exiled with Coffiner's Urn, sacrifice it. If you do, return those cards to play under their owner's control. Now, this can be a great effect when it actually pays off, but it sometimes takes some time to do so. Also, this can easily be removed before its effect actually happens. And finally, there's Face Reward, which is an instant that says return to the battlefield all permanent cards in your graveyard that were put there from the battlefield this turn. We just have some better ways now to protect our board position without having to depend on getting them back when they die. So not only are we going to upgrade our spells, but we're also going to upgrade our lands. It's time to go on to Land Found. First up, we're going to be adding in Command Tower, which is a fantastic addition to any Commander deck. And then there's Exotic Orchard, which can tap to add one mana of any color that a land an opponent controls could produce. Since we're in a 3-color deck, we're bound to hit at least a few of our colors with this card. Next up, we're going to be adding in some improved Selesnya lands. First, there's Canopy Vista, which enters the battlefield tapped unless we control 2 or more basic lands. And Sun Petal Grove enters the battlefield tapped unless we control a forest or a plains. And finally, there's Temple Garden, which when it enters the battlefield, we can pay 2 life, and if we don't, it enters the battlefield tapped. It's always better for us to have lands that have the potential to enter the battlefield untapped. So when we have a bigger budget, it's important for us to upgrade that mana base. So we're also going to upgrade our Simic lands with Hinterland Harbor and Yavimaya Coast. Hinterland Harbor enters the battlefield tapped unless we control a forest or an island. And Yavimaya Coast can either tap for a colorless or can tap for a green or blue mana, but it's going to deal 1 damage to us. And finally, we're going to be upgrading our Azorius lands as well with Prairie Stream, Glacial Fortress, and Port Town. Prairie Stream is going to enter the battlefield tapped unless we control 2 or more basic lands, whereas Glacial Fortress is going to enter the battlefield tapped unless we control a plains or an island. And then there's Port Town, which when it enters the battlefield, we can reveal a plains or an island card from our hand. If we don't, it's going to enter the battlefield tapped. Again, by upgrading our mana base, it makes our deck more consistent and speeds it up. Now these upgraded lands are great, but if you're going to put some in, you've got to take some out, so it's time to go on to Land Lost. First up, we're going to be taking out our slower Selesnya lands with Tranquil Expanse, Selesnya Guildgate, Greatpelt Refuge, and Blossoming Sands. We're going to do the same with Simic and remove those slow lands with Woodland Stream, Simic Guildgate, and Thornwood Falls. And again, we're going to remove our slow Azorius lands with Tranquil Cove, Azorius Guildgate, and Sejuri Refuge. Now that we've gone through every single one of our cards, let's see how this upgraded deck compares in price to others. A quick reminder that deck costs are calculated using TCG player optimization, optimizing with even heavily played and damaged cards because those cards need a home too. Today's average Arcades EDH rec deck is going to set you back $137.24, so let's say we compare to that. Even with all of our upgrades, our deck is still going to be more affordable, coming in at $99.76. And with that, our show is coming to a close, but I really want to hear about what you guys think about these upgrades, so why don't you let me know in the comments below. When you're buying upgrades or decks, make sure you're using our links in the description below. Because not only will you get great prices on TCG Player, but you're also going to be supporting this show because they sponsor us. And make sure you follow us on social media so you can get some early hints on who the next commander just might be for a deck tech or even for a Break the Bank episode. Links to all of our social media accounts can be found in the description. Also in the description below is a link to the Commander's Quarters Patreon page, and I just want to say a quick thank you to the patrons who have subscribed so far. There are many benefits to being a patron for the Commander's Quarters, including being able to vote on future commanders for deck techs. There's even a general tier where you get your own personalized deck tech dedicated to you. I truly couldn't do this without all of your support, so from the bottom of my heart, thank you. If you haven't already, make sure that you like this video and subscribe to the channel, and then check out some of our other episodes on budget deck techs, commander excluded deck techs, and Break the Bank episodes. And with that, I'm out of here. Thanks again, and have a good one.